Hello, Bulldog fans. Welcome into the Samford Sports Wrap-Up. I'm John McAfee. Happy to be joined today by Samford football head coach Chris Hatcher, talking a little early signing day. Coach, thanks for being here.
Well, I appreciate it. Heck, I must be running all the hosts out. I'm on the third one this year, but it's good to be on the show with you today.
Yeah, love having you here, and I would just love to hear about what your thoughts are on the early signing period. Obviously, last year, a little bit of an adjustment for everyone in the first year. Does it feel like a little bit more of a routine now?
It really does. I think it's been an adjustment for not only the college coaches, but the high school coaches. The recruiting process has sped up a great deal now. Last year it was very new. This year it seems like that this is not the early signing period. This is the signing day. And I read a statistic the other day that last year about 70% of all high school student athletes signed in the early signing period. This year, it's going to be anywhere between 90 and 95%. So it's something that we like. Recruiting is not seasonal anymore. It's an everyday deal. And for us, it has really worked out. And I think that, on signing day that, we landed some really top-notch prospects that we're very excited about.
Yeah, when you look at the list of guys coming in, definitely a list heavy on the offensive side of the ball. Of course, you're an offensive coach, and we see a lot of skill players coming in, a couple of receivers, a quarterback, and a couple of running backs as well.
Right now, offensively, we had a little local flavor there, signing the tight end out of Vestavia, Michael Weiss, who caught a touchdown pass in the Alabama-Mississippi All-Star game. Tremendous blocker, great route runner, a position that we we're very much in need of. So we're excited about him. And then we stay local. And we get A.J. Toney out of Jackson Olin. He's a Kelvin McKnight type receiver due to our offense and the success that he had, that Kelvin had. He was excited about joining our squad. So he's a smaller guy as far as height goes, but he's a physical receiver. Great athleticism, so we're excited about him. And then Jason Houston out of Bremen High School is a big 6'5 receiver. Our goal was to sign a taller guy. Putting him on the opposite side of Jai Kramer really adds another dimension to our offense, so we're excited about him. And then our quarterback, Cade Blackman out of Opelika High School, he's a coach's son, has all the intangibles. That really worked out well for us in camp over the summer. So we're really excited about those skill guys joining our team.
And a couple of running backs as well, and Jay Stan and Jaquette Giles.
Well, both of those guys are really good players. Quet Giles is a kid from Florida that has 4.4 speed, very elusive. And we kind of wanted a kind of a home run back, if you will. We feel like he provides that to us. And then Stanton is a little bit bigger guy, that will come in more like what we already have on the team. But he has tremendous ball skills. He's just a really good athlete. So we feel like both of those guys could add some immediate help at a position that we don't have that many players at right now.
You mentioned the McKnight comparison for one of those receivers. I mean, I've got to imagine that helps recruiting some of those skilled players, being able to point to the successes that guys like Hodges and McKnight have had.
Well, sure. If you're a skilled player and our offense doesn't get you excited, I don't know what else will. You look at our running backs. We had a really good year with those guys as well. But we count touches. Those guys touch the ball a lot. We spread the ball out. Of course, our quarterback, is can set all kind of records with the type of offense that we have. So that definitely is something we use in recruiting.
And not just the skill players on the offensive side of the ball, but the linemen as well. Of course, the guys that maybe don't get a lot of the credit, but really important to the offense, obviously.
Well, Chance Butts and Kaz, both of those guys are big guys. They're very athletic for their size. And that's something that, we definitely needed. We need some depth there. That's an area that our depth chart is thin. And the majority of our offensive linemen are going to be seniors this upcoming year. So probably out of all the positions, the offensive line signees were the most crucial to our future success.
And we'll switch to the other side of the ball on the defensive end. Maybe not as much quantity-wise because you've got a kind of a young team already on defense, but a couple of guys with some nice resumes there, a linebacker and a defensive tackle.
Well, there's no question about it. Jamal Ellis is a guy that hasn't played a lot of high school football. And I think if he had, he would have he may have had a few more things going on, but he's a tremendous athlete. He's what we're looking for right there. We feel like we got a steal in him. We really did, and he's got a great family, so we're excited about him. And then Tremarcus Cheeks is a guy we got on early. And boy, I tell you what, again, another steal there. You know, I think all of them were steals, but those two were guys that we kind of went down to the wire with, and we're excited. He's going to provide some big playmaking ability for us at linebacker, and we're really excited about both of those guys joining our defensive squad.
I know this is, it's really early, it might be tough to answer this, but anyone you see really on either side of the ball that maybe you can see slotting in and making an impact right away?
Well, I think that would be unfair to maybe distinguish one or two guys. There's a lot of factors that play into that. First of all, every guy that we sign, we have expectations of them coming in and contributing immediately as a freshman. All guys develop differently, and then some of the guys will have a better shot just because there's not as many on the depth chart at that position to battle at that particular time. So we'll wait and see, but we feel like all 11 that we signed are tremendous ball players. They're great fits for Samford, and they're going to be integral part of us continuing and the success we've had these past four seasons.
And just looking ahead to February, as you mentioned, looking to maybe sign hopefully five more guys, any specific areas of need that you're going to be looking for in that February period?
Well, you know, right now defensively, we'd like another defensive lineman. And then we're looking at maybe taking a combo guy, like either a safety or a corner, or maybe both, you know, depending on who we can get at that particular time. And then we would like to sign another offensive lineman and potentially maybe another quarterback along the way. But those are kind of our wishes to get our numbers balanced out, you know, by position with the 63 scholarships that we're able to have. We've held a couple scholarships back that, you know, over the spring we'll announce. There's a few walk-ons on our team that have performed really, really well that will be awarded scholarships. That's something that I've done since I've been here. And we're excited about that when that time comes around during spring practice.
Coach, appreciate your time. I'm sure we'll talk again in February.
You got it. I appreciate you. And as always, go Dawgs, and I hope everyone has a Merry Christmas.
That's Samford head coach Chris Hatcher. I'm John McAfee. That'll do it for this edition of the Samford Sports Wrap-Up. We'll see you next time.